Let x comma y be a point on parabola y square equal to 4x. Let P be any point that divides the lines, joint points of 0 comma 0 and x comma y in the ratio 1:3. Then the locus of P. Yeah, friends, interesting problem. Y square equal to 4x, standard parabola. First of all, I will draw its diagram. Yeah, listen, friends, this is the y-axis, this is the x-axis, this is the directrix of the parabola. Yeah, this is our parabola. Okay, obviously here vertex is 0, 0, somewhere focus. Okay, I don't want focus now here. X comma y be a point on the parabola. X comma y be a point on the parabola. And vertex and that point are joined with a line segment. Now we want to find out locus of a point which divides this O. I can say this is actually V. I will write V or O, no problem. This is say A. O, yes. In the ratio of 1:3, for example, this is one of such point P, say its coordinates are taken as alpha comma beta, which divides OA in the ratio of 1:3. Then we want to find locus of the point P, means that we want to find a relation between alpha and beta. Okay, that I will write. Let P equal to alpha comma beta be a point on required locus. Locus. So means that P is one of such point. Okay, then. So that is OP is to PA is equal to 1:3. Okay. So A is given as x comma y. Or what I can say, that is, yeah, x comma means a point on the parabola y square equal to 4x, that I will write later. So now I will find out nana locus equation. Yeah, see students, here this is O 0, 0, this is A x comma y, this is variable point P alpha comma beta, dividing in the ratio of 1:3. Directly I can find the coordinates of P by use section formula. So P, that is equal to alpha comma beta, that is equal to mx2 x plus nx1 3:0 by m plus n 1+3 comma my2 1 into y plus ny1 3:0 by 1+3. So directly what I can say, nana alpha comma beta is equal to x by 4 comma y by 4, or I can say that x equal to 4 alpha and y is equal to 4 beta. Okay, actually you want to find the relationship between alpha and beta, nana. So I will write here. So now I got the relationship between alpha and x and beta and y. From that I will find the relation between alpha and beta. A, that is called x comma y, is on parabola. What mean that x comma y should satisfy the condition y square equal to 4x. Means y square means what? 4 beta I can write. Whole square equal to 4 into, instead of x I can write 4 alpha. 16 beta square equal to 16 alpha, or beta square equal to alpha. Beta square equal to alpha is a relationship between alpha and beta. Under this condition, the point P alpha comma beta is moving. So now I can write a conclusion now. Therefore, locus equation. So what we should do, nana, in locus equation, instead of alpha should write x, instead of beta should write y to generalize it. Okay, I will write in. Therefore, the locus equation. Locus equation is y square equal to beta square means y square equal to x. So I can say that my locus equation is y square equal to x. So I can say that my answer is option C. Okay. Next problem. Yeah, a water jet from a fountain reaches its maximum height of 4 meters at a distance of 6.5 meters from the vertical passing through of water outer. So what is the meaning of that? First of all, I will explain. For example, this is the water jet. So water is coming from water jet and it forms a fountain, just like it is a parabolic. Okay, so what this is saying, that a water jet from a fountain reaches its maximum height of 4 meters. For example, this is a base for that. Assume that this is the base for that. Okay, this is the water. Maximum height 4. Maximum height. This is 4. Maximum height is 4. This is 4. Yeah, at a distance of 0.5 meter from the vertical passing through O of the water jet. This is 0.5. Okay, this is the meaning. The height of the jet, peak height of the jet is 4 none. When that is from 0.5 to the outer. Yeah, height of the jet above the horizontal OX. Yeah, as at distance of 0 point, I corrected this, not this is 0.75. Okay, 0.75 meter from the point O. So this is O actually. From here 0.75, somewhere here 0.75. So here you want to find height of the water jet. So this height should find, let it be h. This length is 0.75. We want to find h. Okay, this is the meaning of the problem. What we should do? We want to use coordinate plane to compute the problem. So what I will do, Nana? So I will draw a vertical line here. This I can call as a y-axis. This horizontal line I can call as x-axis. Okay, now I can say that this is a parabola open downwards, and I will compute the problem. Okay, yeah, students, this is my y-axis, this is my x-axis. For mathematical convenience, yeah, this is taken as O. This is taken as O, water outlet. Okay, yeah, this is the fountain. This is peak point. So what is given? This is equal to 4. For this is 0.5. Next one, find this h. So that this length is equal to 0.75. Just I can give some name for that, Nana. I can say this is point A, this is point B, this is point C, this is point D. Okay, so I want to use concept of parabola. Obviously coordinates of B becomes 0.5 comma 4. 0.5 means what? 5 by 10. 1 by 2 comma 4 I can write. Obviously D also I can find its coordinates, that is 0.75 comma h. I can say, Nana, 0 point, I can write that 0.75 comma h, that one. So this is 0.5 comma 4. Obviously 0.75 means 75 by 100. 3s are 4s are 3 by 4. 3 by 4 comma h, I want h. Okay, so students, listen, actually that this is the parabola of the form x square equal to minus 4ay. Actually in general parabola with vertex 0 comma 0 open downwards should have the form x square minus 4ay, just like a shifted type. The axis is parallel to y-axis only. Okay, so what I can say, it is linear in y and quadratic in x. What I can say, that by using this vertex, I can say this is the vertex of the parabola. So what I can say, this equation should have the actual equation of parabola should have the form x minus 1 by 2 whole square equal to minus 4a into y means 1 minus 4, y minus 4, that I will write. Equation of parabola is obviously, yeah, what is that? X minus half whole square equal to minus 4a into y minus 4 completed. Okay. Now what we should do? First of all, you want to find a value. How can I find? I can choose any one output, but clearly given O is the starting point of the water, I can say 0 comma 0. I can say that 0 comma 0 is on the parabola. That I will write. 0 comma 0 is on parabola. Okay. What means that? Instead of x, I can add 0. 0 minus half whole square equal to minus 4a into 0 minus 4. So 0 minus 4 whole square means 1 by 4 equal to, yeah, this is minus plus, yeah, what I can say, 16a, or I can say a equal to 1 by 64. Okay, now I will complete parabola. Again, I will take this is the first one, so I will write in next page. Dana, yeah, it's taking time. Now what I can say, one becomes x minus 1 by 2 whole square equal to 4 into, where is that 4a? A means 1 by 64, so 4 can 16s are, yeah, what I can say, minus 1 by 16, minus 1 by 16 into y minus 4. This is the parabola. Now what I can say, d is also on the parabola. So d, I can say d is on parabola. What is d point actually? 3 by 4 comma h. I can substitute 3 by, instead of x, I can add 3 by 4. 3 by 4 minus 1 by 2 whole square equal to minus 1 by 16 into h minus 4, I can say. So from this we want to find h value. Okay, here 4 LCM, yeah, 3 minus 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 16 is equal to minus 1 by 16 into h minus 4. So 1 by 16, 1 by 16 get cancelled, minus 1 equal to h minus 4. So what I can say, h equal to minus 1 plus 4, or h equal to 3. So the required height of the fountain jet equal to, so 3 meters, h equal to 3 meters. So I can conclude now here. So the height of the jet above the horizontal OX at a distance of 0.75, yeah, meters from the point O is 3 meters, I can say. C is the correct option for that. Yeah, next problem. AB is a chord of the parabola y square equal 4x. With vertex at A, BC drawn perpendicular to AB, meeting the axis at C, then find the projection of BC on the x-axis. Okay, this is also standard parabola. First of all, I want to complete the diagram. So this is y-axis, this is x-axis, this is directrix of the parabola, not required here. Okay, so I want a parabola, this is the parabola whose focus is a comma 0. What are the problem saying that? Vertex is A. BC drawn perpendicular to AB. BC drawn perpendicular to AB and touching the axis at C. Okay. Yeah, AB is the chord. First of all, AB should run in a chord. AB is the chord. Here B, I can say. After that, what happened? BC drawn perpendicular to AB. So what happened here? BC is drawn like this, perpendicular to AB. Meet the axis at the point C. Now we want to find the projection of BC on x-axis. What means that? So this is this perpendicular. This is the projection of BC on x-axis. Say this is a point M. So we want to find MC. Yeah, MC should find. Again, I want to use parametric concept here, shouldn't? That is better one. Okay, first of all I can say that our b is taken as 80 square comma 280. B is taken as 80 square comma 280. Then what happened now? AM is equal to 80 square. It implies AM equal to, I assume that there is a first quadrant, the point, not big problem. AM is equal to 80 square obviously, and BM is equal to 280 obviously. Okay, Ranana. So I want MC. My plan is to find AC first. After finding AC, I will subtract AM, then I will get MC. That is my plan. Okay, yeah. First of all, I want to find equation of BC. For that, first of all, I want to find the slope of AB. From that, I can find slope of BC. Okay, slope of AB. Because obviously, A 0 comma 0 only, standard parabola. No? What I can say that is yeah, 280 minus 0 by 80 square minus 0, that is equal 2 by t. Then slope of BC directly, slope of BC equal to minus t by 2. Since what is the reason? AB is perpendicular to BC, product of the slopes equal to minus 1. Okay, now I can find equation of BC. Equation of BC is y minus y1 280 equal to m means minus t by 2 into x minus x1 80 square. This is the equation of BC, but I don't want to simplify none of this because just I want its x intercept. This is x axis, no? It's x intercept I want. I want to find x intercept, put y equal to 0 in this equation. Directly we get some x value, that only x intercept. Put y equal to 0. What happened? Minus 280 equal to minus t by 2 into x minus 80 square. That I'll put y equal 0 in 1, I can say. Okay. What happened on here? Tt get cancelled. Minus minus get cancelled. So what happened? 4a equal to, I will write in next page. Yeah, what I got? 4, 1 minute. Excuse me. Yeah. What I got? 4a equal to x minus 80 square. So x is equal to what, Nana? 4a plus 80 square. Okay. So what is x means that in the coordinate, for x coordinate of the point C, directly I can say that C equal to 4a plus 80 square comma 0. Okay. Now what I want, this is actually, that is nothing but AC only, AC length. Oh shit. Okay, so that is nothing but AC, Nana. I can't show you because that is erased at the diagram. No problem, you people can see that. So what I got, AC equal to 4a plus 80 square. AC, that one. Already AM we have. AM is we have as 80 square. So therefore what I want? CM I want. CM equal to AC minus AM. So 4A plus 80 square minus 80 square. So that I can say 4A. Therefore projection of BC on X axis 4A. I can say my answer is 4A. Okay. This is our next question, students. An equilateral triangle SAB is inscribed in parabola y square equal to 4x. Interesting problem. Having its focus at S, if chord AB lies towards the left side of S, then side of the length of the triangle. Interesting problem, students. Listen, what happened in a parabola, standard parabola y square equal to 4x, S is focus. So SAB in equilateral triangle is SAB. Inscribed and AB lies toward the left side of this, here AB. So important thing, students, very important thing, by line symmetry concept or symmetry concept, I can say that this side means this curve or the side AB is just like a double ordinate for the parabola. Then only we will get a equilateral triangle. I can say that SAB is an equilateral triangle, so that AB is one of its double ordinate. Using this concept, I want to find out what you want. You want to find length of the side of the equilateral triangle. Okay, now I will complete the diagram. Yeah, students, listen. This is y-axis. This is x-axis. This is directrix. So this is our parabola. Okay. Focus is here, S. Now I want to write triangle now here. I want to write triangle. Yeah. So that what I can say, my AB is one of double ordinate. AB. So this is joint. This is joint. Actually, this equilateral triangle, this is 60. This is 60, total 60. Well, line symmetry concept, I can, this is 30 and this is 30. This is x-axis. Or in other words, I can say that inclination of SA equal to 150 degree. Because total 180, no? That is important thing for me. Okay? Yeah. Listen. Inclination of AB, AS is 150 degree. Again here I want to use a symmetric form of a straight line or parametric form of a straight line. And here parametric equation of a straight line, for example, S is given here. Obviously S is a comma 0 only. S is a comma 0. Now I want to find out a point A, which is I'm using that let's assume that side of the equal triangle is BR. Then what I can say that I want to find out a point on the same line which is r units from S, means directly what I can say, this is nothing but a plus r cos 150 comma 0 plus r sin 150. From that I can find the coordinates of A. Okay, I hope you people understood. So that I will write here, let r be the length of side of triangle means equilateral triangle here. All sides are equal in length. Okay, so now directly I can find the coordinates of A by using parametric equation of a straight line concept. So A equal to directly A plus R into cos 150 degree comma 0 plus R into sin 150 degree. Students, listen, Anna, here this is A as it is, R as it is, cos 150, cos 90 plus 60, second quadrant minus sin 60, minus root 3 by 2. Directly I will write minus, what I can say that, minus root 3 R by 2, comma 0 plus R into sin plus cos 60 1 by 2, I can say R by 2. Okay, now A is equal to A minus root 3 R by 2 comma R by 2. Obviously, the point is on the parabola. I can substitute in the parabola. From that, we get R. I will write in next page. A, that is equal to A minus root 3 R by 2 comma R by 2 is on. Y square equal to 4ax. What I can say now, y square means r by 2 whole square equal to 4a. X means what I can write nana, a minus root 3 by 2 r. Okay, r square by 4 equal to 4a into 2a minus root 3 r by 2. 2 1s are 2 2s are. So R square equal to 8A times of 2A minus root 3 R. Okay, R square, plus 8A root 3 R, okay, minus 16A square equal to 0, is a quadratic. So I want to find R value. I can use quadratic equation concept. R equal to minus B minus 8A root 3 plus r minus root over b square means 64 a square into 3. Okay, minus 4ab, minus into minus plus 4 into a means 1, 16 a square. by by yeah 2a 2 okay nana so here only I will compute the remaining result students yeah so 64 a square can take common so what I can say r equal to minus 8a into root 3 here I can't take plus or minus nana if you take minus 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 total minus radius won't be in negative or radius is not no side no side should not be negative that's why I can't take here minus I can take only plus plus yeah 64 a square taken common 8a it becomes root over 3 plus 1 okay by 2 so totally I can take yeah 8 minus okay I will rewrite again so minus 4a root 3 plus 4a into that is 2 what I can say 8a minus 4a root 3 this is the length of the side of equal triangle or another words I can say that what I can take 4a I can take common 2 minus root 3 so this is the side of an equilateral triangle with the given conditions so I will see nana 4a times of 2 minus root 3 4a times of 2 minus root. I can go with option B